Right, so now that the camera is set, we can proceed with lighting the bottle here. And you know, initially I added these two lights on the set just to add some ambient light while I composed the shot. And now that I have composed the shot, so I'll again remove these lights and start building the lighting set one light at a time. So I'll be removing the top light and I'll be starting with that light to light the wooden base and create some nice refractions through the bottle and the glasses. So let me just remove this top light. And by the way, you know, let's say if I'm doing a commercial shoot, so I would never experiment with the lights once the clients are here. As you know, these things take a lot of time. So I always do this that either one day prior to the shoot or early morning on the day of the shoot, I would experiment with the lights and be prepared with the first shot before the clients are here. So that, you know, once the client is here, I have something to show it to them and then we can proceed with the rest of the shoot from there. So let me just remove the top light and start lighting the bottle. Right, so now this is the very first light on the set and basically I'm using a standard reflector with a 20 degree grid here. And you know why I'm using a grid here is because I want to create a glow around the products. And at the same time, I want the edges and the background to gradually fade into darkness. And that's the reason I'm using a grid here to control the beam of light and focus it on a particular spot. So let's say if I remove this grid here, and now if you can see, the light is spilling all across the frame, but I don't want that. So that's the reason I'm using this grid to really narrow down the beam of light and focus it on a specific spot. And also, you know, I've kept the light in this position because I want to create the shadows and refractions in that direction, which is on the right side of the bottle. And, you know, while composing the shot, accordingly, I have left some space over there. So let's take the first shot with the light in this position, see the result, and then accordingly, I can make the changes and adjust the light. So I'm taking the first shot using this remote shutter release, and the camera waits for 3 seconds, take the shot, and then we can see what exactly it, okay. So the very first shot is heavily overexposed. And although my aperture is at f5.6 and I'm at base ISO of 100, this light is also at its minimum power. And yet we are getting a heavily overexposed shot. So this means that I'll have to use a filter. And let's put a filter on the lens and see how it changes the result. Right, so let me first remove this lens hood here and put an adapter ring. So, you know, I'm being very careful while handling the filters. Right, so this is the adapter ring that simply goes in front of the lens. Like this, and then I can attach this filter holder on this adapter ring. Perfect. So here I'm using this CPL, which also kind of acts like a, let's say, 2 to 3 stop ND filter. Let me just put it in and let's see if polarization makes any difference here. Okay, so right now I'm at zero polarization. Let's take a shot. Okay. And let's kill the reflections completely. So I'm going at full polarization. Somewhere there. Let's take another shot. Okay, that's quite a difference. And I also want to take one shot somewhere in the middle. So, right there. Okay, great. So now we can compare the results and see which one works best for us. So this is the one without any filter. And this is the one with the filter and full polarization. And then I have these three. So let's compare these three results. Right, so all these three are with the filter at different polarizations. So this one right here is at zero polarization. This one is at complete polarization, killing all the reflections. And this is somewhere in the middle. So if I see, I don't like this one because this is looking very flat. I mean, it has killed the reflections completely. Although we can really nicely see the color of the wood here, but the overall image looks very flat. And this one on the left, this is still overexposed and the color of the wood is completely washed out. Whereas this one, I really like this on the right side. So, you know, this has retained the color of the wood and at the same time it has retained the glow as well. So let's go ahead with this one on the right. I like it. Yeah, so this is the one. And now I'll change the lighting and see what difference the light makes. Right, so now I'm quite happy with the exposure, but I'm still not getting those dark edges around the products. And I think I basically need to narrow down this spot of light. So, you know, this beam of light, I need to make it even narrower, a smaller spot on the products. And right now I'm using a 20 degree grid here. So let me replace it with a, let's say, 8 degree grid and see what difference that makes. So I just get an 8 degree grid. Yeah. Right, so this grid will give me a narrower spot on the products. So let me see if I put it here. And in fact, let me also switch off the video light and turn on the live view so we can actually see what this light is doing here on the products. So I'll just turn off the video lights and switch on the live view here. Yeah. So now let me adjust this light, and if I move it, and as you can see, you know, it's a game of centimeters and millimeters. You know, I have to move this light very precisely to get the spot right in the center just behind the bottle so that I get dark edges. And I'm also getting this nice refraction on the right side of the bottle. In fact, let me just see if, what if I make these refractions on the left side? How does it look? Let me see. Okay. Now I think I like the previous refractions better. So let me just put it back and adjust the light so that I get the refraction at the right spot. Yeah. Right there. Right there it looks good. Let me lock it. Right, so the light looks good. Let me take a shot and see. Wow, that's a huge difference. If I compare it with this, the previous shot, as you can see, this shot is taken with a 20 degree grid and this one is taken with an 8 degree grid. If you look at them side by side, that's a huge difference. So I really like what an 8 degree grid is doing. So this one, we are good to go with this one, right? And I think the focus is a little off here, okay. Right, the focus looks off. So I might have moved the camera. So let me just fix the focus here. There it looks good, okay. And let's take a shot. Yeah, that looks much better. Absolutely. So now the bottle is in tack sharp focus, the label, and the light looks good. Yeah. So now let me add another light to create a flare coming from the top right corner. Let's do that. Let's add another light. All Right, so I'm adding the second light on the set, and let me just switch on the video light so you can see what I'm doing here. Okay, so basically this is a similar standard reflector with a grid, and I'm adding this light to create some nice flare coming from the top right side of the photo and hitting the bottle. And at the same time, I also want this light to create some specular highlight on the on here, on the shoulders and the neck here. So that the bottle, the glass bottle actually looks like glass in the final shot. Because sometimes, you know, what happens is that, let's say if I create some nice gradient highlights on the glass bottle, the glass might end up looking like a matte surface. And because I don't want that, so I'm creating some nice specular highlights on the shoulder and the neck. So let's do that. And to create a flare, you need to position the light so that it points directly towards the camera, because the light should hit the sensor directly to create some nice flare. So I think I'll need to move this light a little bit down and point it towards the camera like this. And let me just plug this in. Okay. So yeah, down like this, and this light should be pointing straight towards the camera. So let's move it up a bit. That should be a good starting point. And let me just switch on the live view so we can see what this light is doing. Right, so let me just take this light off of the stand so we can see where it will create a flare. So I'm trying to point this light right. Oh, nice. So I can actually see the flare in the live view. Right, so it is. I'm just trying to point this light straight into the camera. Right there. So we can see some flare at the top right corner. So let's say if we, right, oh, nice, nice, nice. So there, right there, I can see some flare across the neck. And at the same time, I'm also seeing some nice specular highlights on the shoulders right here. If you can see this one right here, right. So let's position the light somewhere here. Let me put it back on the stand. Now I'll need to figure out the exact position. Oh, nice. It looks good right here. And at the same time, you know, I don't want this light to spill on the wooden surface, because I really like what this light is doing. So that is the reason I'm also pointing it up towards the camera as much as possible, so to avoid the light hitting on the wooden surface. And I can see a flare coming right across the neck of the bottle in the live view. So let's take a shot here and see if it creates a flare in the shot or not. Okay, so there we go. Nice. So I'm getting a nice flare across the neck here, but this light has completely washed out the background. The light on the wood is completely gone. But I'm getting nice specular highlights on the neck here. Okay, so let's see if I change the grid here, if that makes any difference or not. So right now I'm using the widest grid. Let me just replace it with this one, which will give me a narrower beam of light. Let's take a shot and see. Okay, I think the light didn't fire. Right. Okay, now we can compare. It does make a difference, but that is not enough. The background is still washed out. So let me put a narrower grid. and see if that makes any difference. So now I'm putting the same 8-degree grid that is here on this slide. Let's take a shot again. Okay, that does make a difference, but again, not much. But here I'm not liking the specular highlights are almost gone here. Whereas when I was using the widest grid, I can see nice specular highlights on the neck right here. So another thing we can do is, you know, let's just switch back to the widest grid, and then I can use something to block some light here. Let's just put the widest grid back here, which is this one right here. And now let's take a shot again. Okay, so I'm again seeing the specular highlights on the neck. So now what we can do is, let's add a black card here. So this is just a black chart paper that I'm keeping it here to block some light from hitting the wooden surface. Let me just keep it here and see. All right, so this looks much better. Much better. I'm again recovering the edges. I mean, the edges are dark again. And we still have some nice specular highlights on the neck. I think let me just adjust it a bit. Might have killed the flare too much. So let me just pull it back a little. Nice. So I'm liking the highlights, the specular highlights on the bottle. The flare is a little too strong here. Let me just adjust it a bit. So I'm pulling it up again. Just a little bit. So you know, this is what you need to do. You just need to make very small adjustments when lighting a product, because these small adjustments here can make a big difference in the photo. Alright, let's compare this one. I like it. This actually looks good. So if I compare it to the very first shot without the black card. So here we can see it's much better. With the black card, it's much better. So this shot on the right looks much better as the edges are dark, as compared to this shot. So let's also compare it with the one without the flare. Okay, this one. Let's see if flare actually looks good or not. Right. I think the flare is really adding to the overall look and feel of the photo. I like it. I like what the flare is doing here on the right. And I like the specular highlights on the neck and the shoulder. So let's move ahead with this shot. It's looking good. Nice.